Is it coming out of commercial or is it my... Good.
Yes, sir. Same in there, guys. Everybody great.
Επειδή το καλοκαίρι σας αρέσει να χαλαρώνετε, εμείς τρέχουμε περισσότερο. Καλοκαίρι είναι πιο συναρπαστικό με Super Sport.
Confident as they've won three games on the road already in this postseason, including game one of this series. Two confident teams. Let's send it to our sideline reporter, Andrea Joyce.
All right, Mike, I spoke to Vince Carter when he arrived here at the arena about 2 hours ago. When I first saw him, I jokingly said, you look different as a college graduate. He beamed and said, you know, I feel different. Well, that was the last smile we got from Vince Carter. To say that he put on a game face may sound like a cliche, but it would also be an understatement. It was clear that he wanted to separate these two events. He told me that he's glad the graduation ceremony is over and he just wants to focus now on game seven. And when I asked him about the criticism he's taken during the last 48 hours, some of it from his fellow teammates, he first said he didn't want to comment about it and then said, I don't care, I just want to play. So his focus now is definitely on this game. Back to you, Mike.
All right, Andrew. Caution criticism now, but if things don't go well, he has really opened himself up, Bill.
It's easy to come after the fact, but what he has done has been a remarkable accomplishment. And while we want to credit that, we also have to be careful not to get too caught up in the ceremony, in the recognition of that, and realize that there is a big battle, a battle today, a fresh game to be won.
And Doug, he looks like he's ready to play.
You know what? A few jump shots early, the teammates will forget that he was not here with the team last night. If he plays great, they will love him.
Critical for Philadelphia. Get off to a fast start. Whoever has got the early lead has been the best.
And there you see game sevens for so long, the home team dominant. They went 20 straight over a 13-year period, but the road team has won three of the last nine game sevens. And as we mentioned, the Raptors have won some big road games in the playoffs. They won in New York in game five to advance to this series, so they have some road confidence. Danny Crawford, one of the premier officials of the game, throws it up. Crawford, Dick Pavetta, and Eddie F. Rush. As you see, Iverson, Mutombo, doing so many things for Philadelphia.
Get Iverson on the move.
First shot won't go, but Mutombo with the rebound. Comes up short, and Morris Peterson, who had such a fine game in game six, getting the start again. Carter, his first shot. Iverson the rebound. Ball knocked loose. Good play from Peterson to deflect it. And Carter coming the other way. Peterson lost the handle. All right, guys. In such a game like this, when do the unbelievable nerves wear off and you settle down?
I've always felt like about the first 8 minutes is all energy, emotion, and then the last 40 comes down the best team, execution. As guys start to get tired, they slow down, they perform better.
You're not nervous in these games. It's what you live for. It's what you train your whole life to play in these moments. Anxious, not nervousness.
A loose ball foul call against Tyrone Hill. I think whoever says they're not nervous is not telling the truth. You're a man of steel in terms of nerves, Bill.
It's how you prepare. It's how you discipline yourself over the course of a lifetime. So when you walk out there, you know this moment belongs to you.
McKeon, Morris Peterson, Davis makes a move inside. Antonio Davis, who has just been superb in these postseason.
They're going to call it a layup game there.
Yep. That's the call from Dick Pavetta.
See, Mike, I think what you can see what happens there with Mutombo, he does not move his feet that well. He loves to play close to the basket. And when Antonio Davis has done this entire series, is step out on the floor, shoot jump shots, and then beat him with that quick dribble that we saw in the last possession.
And Larry Brown has really been begging his Dikembe to get out and play Antonio Davis as if he's a perimeter player.
Jermaine Jones. Short. Jones, of course, starting with George Lynch out for the rest of the postseason after having surgery on that broken foot.
Larry Brown insistent on transition defense.
Davis comes up short. Mutombo, another rebound.
And one of the things now with Antonio Davis shooting a lot of jumpers, they miss his offensive rebounding, and that is real critical for this Toronto team. Second shot, they're third in the league.
McKee is open. That's a two for Aaron McKee, and the Sixers get on the board.
Whenever Philadelphia gets into a dead set offensive play, Toronto with Lenny Wilkins' strategies to run at Allen Iverson to make him give it up. Aaron McKee, Jermaine Jones are going to have to knock down the perimeter shots.
Oakley wide open, puts it in. Charles Oakley, who seems to love road games in the playoffs. He had a big smile on his face during the introductions.
Now, do you think Charles Oakley's nervous today?
All right, I'll give you that one. Oakley's not nervous. Mutombo, Davis knocks it away. Mutombo wanted a foul. Iverson with the steal. Goes inside.
See, that's what you want if you're Allen Iverson. You're coming off a 6-for-24 game. Get yourself an easy one.
Oakley again wide open and knocks it down.
Somehow, Toronto has to find a way to quiet this crowd. An electric atmosphere, one of the best in the entire league. This crowd hungry and thirsty for victory.
Single coverage on Mutombo. Carter now tries to help. Mutombo gets inside, and a foul is called on Antonio Davis. Iverson's averaging 3.5 steals a game in this series.
Well, he leads the NBA in steals, and you cannot be careless with outlet passes. Allen Iverson is always going to hang around and try to play that pass. And again, Bill, you know that if you've struggled, you want to get something easy. Get the feeling of that ball going in the basket. Get that positive feeling. Makes that jump start to fall. So get him to the foul line. Get him some layups. It opens up the entire game for Allen Iverson.
Norris Peterson guilty of that turnover for Toronto. When you're reading outlet passes, you have got to see defenders. You've got to see where guys are coming up and throw away from them.
Mutombo hits the first. The Sixers, a big disparity in terms of free throw attempts. They've taken 152 now in the series to just 107 for Toronto.
If you want to look at two keys, when Toronto wins that three-point line, they're tough to beat. And when the Sixers win the free throw line and the turnovers, they're tough to beat. We'll see what happens here today.
Oakley misfires that time, and here comes McKee.
Three guys on Iverson, five guys.
Tyrone Hill, and Hill able to put it in. Hill coming off a solid game in game six, one of the few Sixers who played well.
Inspiring greatness in others, Allen Iverson setting up guys.
Carter back to the rim, Mutombo, another rebound.
Two jumpers, two misses for Carter, offensive foul.
Maurice Peterson has already made three excellent defensive plays. Of course, he's a terrific three-point shooter, but he's doing some good things on the other end.
Well, you know, when I talked to Larry Brown before the game, Mike, he said the pace of the game is important to us, but we can't turn the ball over. Aaron McKee looked like he had the shot there, tried to drive it to the basket, and Mo Peterson did a nice job there reading that play.
Morris Peterson, of course, the rookie from Michigan State, said he couldn't sleep before game six when he was told he was going to start. Gets inside on Jermaine Jones, just flips it up, not a good shot. And Jones quick out there. Iverson on the pull-up. And Jones rips it down, and his foul on the follow. Jermaine Jones will shoot two.
The athleticism that Jermaine Jones brings. Started the last two games after George Lynch broke his foot. But with Allen Iverson pushing the ball, setting a pace where they want to run on offense, but keep Toronto from running, Jermaine Jones just quick up the floor. And well, Morris Peterson, he has to do a much better job of focusing in on keeping Jermaine Jones off that offensive glass.
Well, you can see Philadelphia, Bill, on the season, they did not shoot a high percentage. When you don't shoot a high percentage, what do? You got to get second shots. And so when Philadelphia is playing well, these guys, Jermaine Jones, Mutombo, Tyrone Hill, that's how they score off Allen Iverson's misses. So when he gets his shots, those guys feed off of his misses. That's the way they score.
All five starters have scored for the Sixers, who are now on a 6-0 run and lead by four. Gone by the opening quarter.
If you're a rebounder, you love playing ball with Allen Iverson.
Well, he draws so much attention. All you have to do is go to the boards, Bill. You know that.
And his shot is easy to read.
Carter on the follow. And Vince Carter with his first 2 points of the game.
Whenever there's controversy, the guy who's at the center of it has to come out with an initial charge and make a big play to take all that pressure off, to defuse the focus.
Tyrone Hill blocked by Davis. Mutombo, the second effort for Philly.
All the hustle plays earlier going to Philadelphia right now, they're about a half step quicker. And in a game like this, Bill, easy baskets many times determine who's going to win the game.
And Toronto's getting none of them. Their game is fast break. Their game is ball movement, perimeter shooting.
Peterson misses the two. Tyrone Hill the rebound. Iverson again, seeing the double team, much like game six.
You've got to break the play if you're Jermaine Jones. Don't sit there and think about the set offense.
That's a three.
Long rebound tipped by Iverson, knocked out of bounds, and the Raptors will get it.
Everybody begging out there.
Well, it's going to be interesting. Allen Iverson is using so much energy here early in this game. He's fighting double teams, triple teams. He's pushing the ball up the floor. Now, I know this guy has tremendous energy, but he's going to have to play the entire 48 minutes. Well, he's going to have to get himself in a little bit of a rhythm here.
Playing at home, though, will help tremendously. Fourth shot, Vince able to get it back on the second effort.
Carter, both his field goals on tip-ins after misses. And the Raptors within two. Iverson, a long three.
Plus, I think having the poor game on Friday night in game six will also be an edge to Iverson.
Well, no question. You're at home and you get a couple easy baskets. Now you hit a three. That basket starts looking real big if you're a shooter.
He's shooting over 44% from three-point range in this series.
When he started in his league, he couldn't buy one from that distance.
Antonio Davis answers back. And the Sixers lead cut to three. Early substitution for Philly. There's Eric Snow bringing the ball up. And Larry Brown will call timeout. Fast pace early in this one. As Vince Carter showing some hops early, guys.
Vince Carter throws it up basically like Moses Malone, like Charles Barkley, just trying to get it back.
When we talk about stars, here's Allen Iverson going to answer it. He comes off the screen, the quick release three. The stars are off. We got a great start here. The Sixers lead by three. You guys okay with it? You okay, Bill?
Perfect.
All right.
The Axe Effect.
Επειδή το καλοκαίρι σας αρέσει να αλλάζετε ρυθμούς, εμείς σας προτείνουμε την ταχύτητα. Η πιο γρήγορη οδική του πλανήτη στις πιο δύσκολες διαδρομές. Τα πιο γρήγορα σερβίς στον κόσμο. Τα ταχύτερα center for της Λατινικής Αμερικής. Το καλοκαίρι σπάστε όλα τα ρεκόρ ταχύτητας μόνο στο Supersport. Η πρώτη θέση της κανονικής περιόδου είναι το μεγάλο στοίχημα για Περιστέρι και Παναθηναϊκό στο συγκλονιστικό φινάλε της Τετάρτης. Το γηπεδούχο Περιστέρι θέλει νίκη με διαφορά 10 πόντων, ενώ στον Παναθηναϊκό αρκεί να προστατεύσει τη διαφορά των 9 πόντων, με την οποία κέρδισε στον αγώνα του πρώτου γύρου. Δείτε αυτή την Τετάρτη Περιστέρι Παναθηναϊκό. Ζωντανά και αποκλειστικά από το Super Sport.
Yeah, okay, okay. Yeah, I talked to Larry about that a little bit this morning. Thanks.
Sixers by three. Allen Iverson seeing a lot of double teams once again, Doug.
Well, Mike, when you're going to play with Allen Iverson, he's got to get this kind of attention. You can't stand around and watch him play. You've got to be ready. The double team, he finds Aaron McKee. He steps up and he hits the jump shot. This time he's going to draw three defenders. Baseline, he's going to find Tyrone Hill, who lays the ball in the basket. He finally gets single coverage, comes off a screen and buries the three. So he's got his teammates involved. But Bill, you know, if he's going to get that kind of attention, they've got to be ready to shoot the basket. basketball.
In the locker room before the game, Allen started a conversation by saying, I'm going to try not to do too much today, and then caught himself immediately. He said, wait a second, I'm going to do it all.
We asked Larry Brown if he was concerned about that. He said, absolutely not. Eric Snow's first shot knocks it down.
Now, that's a real positive sign, because you know that Toronto's going to run off Eric Snow. He's got a very sore ankle. He jammed it in game six, re-aggravated it, been coming off the bench to try to keep his minutes down, but he is a crunch time player for them.
He was listed as questionable, but said the only way he's not going to play is if Larry Brown doesn't use him, as Hill brings in the Peterson miss.
You can just see Eric Snow's right ankle bothering the gimpy gait that he has. But when he gets a wide open shot, he's been deadly.
Hill as well with the wide open shot. Tyrone Hill, the most experienced playoff performer for the Sixers, has got 4 points.
Superior ball movement and perimeter shooting, keys throughout this whole series to winning the game.
And the lead up to 7. Snow is now on Carter. Alvin Williams got bumped by Hill. 2-on-1 break. Oakley is back. Blocked from behind by Carter. Charles Oakley, good defensive play, but then throws it away in the wrong spot. That's a cardinal sin on those passes.
Charles Oakley does not have great balance, Bill, when he gets a lot of those rebounds. He gets himself falling forward. The ball is going out of bounds, and Allen Iverson, another easy basket. So now he's got a steal on the outlet pass. He picks up that loose ball. Now you give him 2 layups. That leads to trouble if you're Toronto.
Goodness gracious sakes, like how many times they had to tell you not to throw the outlet pass down the middle of the floor. The block shot by Vince Carter, but Philadelphia stays with it while everybody runs away. Referees with the whistles in the pockets, allowing Allen Iverson and the Sixers to extend out of the timeout to now a 9-point lead, Philly.
And turnovers hurting the Raptors early. Sixers on a 17-6 run. They lead by 9.
Επειδή είστε εθισμένοι στα σπορτ, αυτό το καλοκαίρι μπήκαμε στο μυαλό σας. Εμείς σας προσφέρουμε το πάθος και την ένταση των μεγάλων τελικών. Τελική Α1 μπάσκετ. Τελική NBA. Τελική Wimbledon. Τελικός Copa America. Αυτό το καλοκαίρι οι μεγάλοι τελικοί παίζουν μόνο στο Super Sport. Η δύναμη του Σακίλ Ονίλ κοντρά στους δίδυμους πύργους του Σαν Αντώνιο, Τιμ Ντάνκαν και Ντέιβιντ Ρόμπινσον. Οι τελικοί της Δύσης στο NBA συγκλονίζουν και κόβουν την ανάσα. Ποιος θα πάει στους τελικούς του NBA? Οι πρωταθλητές του 99 Spurs ή οι περσινοί θριαμβευτές Lakers? Δείτε τα ξημερώματα του Σαββάτου τον τρίτο τελικό της Δύσης, Lakers Σαν Αντώνιο. Βλέπετε NBA ζωντανά και αποκλειστικά από το Super Sport. Τώρα τα αθλητικά έχουν το δικό τους παιχνίδι. Super Sport Game. Interactive παιχνίδι για όλους τους φίλους των σπορ. Δοκιμάστε τις γνώσεις σας σε ένα quiz αθλητικών ερωτήσεων. Όταν δείτε το σήμα του Super Sport Game στους αγώνες του ελληνικού πρωταθλήματος ποδοσφαίρου και μπάσκετ, πατήστε OK. Απαντήστε σωστά στις 4 ερωτήσεις και μπείτε στην κλήρωση για πολλά και πλούσια δώρα. Super Sport Game. Το παιχνίδι των πρωταθλητών. Μόνο στο Super Sport. Αποκλειστικά στην Nova. Παίξτε Super Sport Game. Παρέα με τα Pringles.
Brown told his team it's like an NCAA tournament game yesterday. One and you're out. That's certainly the case in game seven. And Philadelphia off to a good start, which wasn't always the case in this series, Doug.
Well, in games one and two, they dug themselves huge holes. Got them. Look at this. These are the first two games at home. Finally, they get a lead, 11-0, 33-12 at the end of one, and they win by 34. So very positive sign that they have not gotten off to a slow start. And that's the one thing Larry Brown spoke to me about today. We have got to get off to a great start. Keep this crowd electric behind us. Have them drive us to the finish.
Chris Childs in the game for the Raptors. Toronto's turned the ball over four times already. They had eight total turnovers in game six. During the regular season, they were the best in the league in fewest turnovers.
The responsibility comes to Vince Carter to start igniting his team. Alvin keeping Chris Childs now in the game and Cole from the perimeter.
Good rebound from McKee. Getting inside, draws the foul on Alvin Williams. Crowd calling for a goaltend, as is Eric Snow, as is Larry Brown. But it's going to be two shots coming up from McKee as Alvin Williams picks up his first.
Doug, it's a follow-up to your point about the quick lead. As good a basketball as we've seen in this series, particularly between the two superstars, been very few close games.
Right.
And very few momentum swings. It's been a big start, and the other team is basically full, particularly the last two games.
Take a look here to see if it's a goaltend. Nah, that ball had no chance to go in.
The ball
in.
Was coming to the front to the foul line after it hit the corner of the board.
So McKee hits the first. One of the fun things about this series is you've had the spectacular performances of Vince Carter and Allen Iverson, but you've seen some of the best role-type players in the NBA, guys like Aaron McKee, Antonio Davis. Now, they're more than role players, but a supporting cast, and it's great to see those guys get their due.
You're going to talk about role players. You got to talk about the Laker role players. Both guys are playing.
Williams way short on that three. The scramble and a jump ball. Good effort from both teams. And they'll jump it up at the Raptors' free throw line circle.
Every loose ball, every long rebound, virtually every second effort has gone Philadelphia's way. But Toronto still stuck on 12 for a seeming eternity here. Now Vince Carter desperately needs something going.
Carter wins it. Oakley tries to save it, but throws it out of bounds.
You know, to me, that was a prime example of guys who their careers have not grown up with jump balls. That's a play you've got to be able to control right there. Carter's got the tip. He tips it out of bounds. See, these guys are used to alternate possession coming out of college. They don't play read the tipper's eyes, stealing tip. No, they don't do that. They didn't grow up like you and I.
In the NBA,
hey,
you got to
throw it up. How many jump balls did you get, Tom?
I stole a lot. I didn't get any tips.
Snow bounces back. Another one of those players we're talking about, Eric Snow. Such a team first, thinks defense, unselfish player. And playing hurt puts the Sixers up by 13. The Sixers with excellent defense here in the early going. Carter with six on the shot clock. Knocks it down.
No defense whatsoever to that. I mean, Vince Carter just too good. Explosion, catch and shoot without even seeing the rim.
That's why it's so important to get him to catch it outside his range so you force him to put it on the floor, then you can get help.
That's been one of the incredible things about these 50-point performances is McKee is fouled. Carter's playing against McKee. McKee's a terrific defender. Iverson's been playing against Alvin Williams. He's a terrific defender.
One of the keys for Vince Carter is to catch the ball on the move. Here he just turns and shoots immediately. A fantastic execution of the inside pivot, giving even the best of defenders no chance whatsoever.
Williams sits down. Del Curry in the game.
Now, Del Curry is in for one reason, to make open shots. And in game one, he was a big difference in this series. Came off the bench, had 20 points. So if Carter's going to get a lot of attention, they'll spread the floor, and Del Curry will make open shots. So Philadelphia better get to him as soon as he gets in that offensive category. They're down in that offensive zone, Bill, where they cannot let him get those open shots.
Unfortunately for Lenny Wilkins, since game one, Del Curry has really given them zilch.
Well, that's what happens when you get ready for a series. You say, you know what, he comes in, no open shots.
Carter, by the way, picked up that foul. Childs for three. He comes up short. Mutombo tips it beautifully to Snow. 3-on-2 break for the Sixers. McKee. And Davis hauls it in. Free throw shooting early. Sixers 8 for 8. Raptors have yet to go to the line.
That's the story of this entire series. And who for Toronto is going to be able to create a shot, get to the foul line, and then knock it down.
Antonio Davis knocks him down. And he's got 6 points.
Where did he get that?
Well, you know, when you're playing against Mutombo, you have to make that shot. But, Bill, when you step Antonio Davis off, he's not going to shoot free throws. And Vince Carter has got to get in there and get some contact, not just be a jump shooter.
McKee, beautiful backdoor on a give and go.
Iverson draws so much attention. The ball comes to Allen's hands. Everybody turns and looks. The back cut executed perfectly.
Iverson with 5 assists already, Bill.
He's a little bit tired to me.
Not at all. Carter spinning inside, and there's the foul. And the Raptors will shoot their first free throws.
Bringing the ball up the court. Aaron McKee, Eric Snow, whoever. Get the ball in the corner where Iverson can move. Everybody's looking, taking a peek. If you keep moving when you're playing with a great player, and Doug, you played with a lot of them, if you're on the move constantly, you're going to get that ball back.
Well, what it also does, too, Bill, if you're moving, it forces the other team maybe to have to play you a little more honestly as the offensive player, and you give that star player more room to work. When you stand around and watch a great player, all of a sudden now all eyes go to him, and you can double and triple team him.
I'm amazed when I watch these games, and you've got Allen Iverson, Vince Carter, Kobe Bryant, Shaquille O'Neal, Tim Duncan, David Robinson. When those guys have the ball, people are standing, people are walking, not even looking at the ball. They'll change the pace, change the direction, right to the hoop. You're going to get a layup virtually every time.
Carter hits the free throws. Iverson from way downtown won't go. And Curry the rebound.
That's a Doug Collins heat check right there.
McKee right on it. There's a double. Childs another open three. And puts it in. Chris Childs, of course, was acquired for games like this. So many tough playoff performances with the New York Knicks. And he knocks down his first field goal.
Toronto has much more playoff experience than Philadelphia. You mentioned Tyrone Hill's experience. Eric Snow was a deep reserve on the Seattle Sonics team that went to the finals in 1996. Eric Snow on the plane ride home from Toronto after the dismal performance game six. Eric called all the guys together and talked about the specialness of winning this final game at home.
So Snow sits down. Iverson hits the first. Log on to MSNBCSports.com for in-depth playoff coverage, including previews of each game of the Lakers-Spurs series and, of course, the upcoming Eastern Conference Finals, plus Matt Kukas and Steve Jones breaking down the matchups and picking the winners. And email Bill your playoff questions and get his take on free agent Chris Webber's future, all at MSNBCSports.com.
Jerome Williams in the game now for Toronto. A lot of energy, whereas Oakley will step out and shoot the jumpers. Jerome will be on that offensive backboard.
Aaron McKee's defense has been very solid against Vince Carter.
Carter, three-pointer won't go. Davis tracks down the offensive rebound.
To get the last shot of the quarter here. Spread it out, let Carter work.
Shot clock turned off. Final seconds of the opening period.
I think get to the hoop, try to get a free throw attempt.
Davis from way outside. Mutombo altering that shot. And that will end the first quarter. A strong one for the Philadelphia 76ers, and Iverson doing some scoring and some distributing as well. Iverson with 5 assists already as the Sixers shoot 50% from the field in the opening period. One quarter complete here at the First Union Center. Sixers by 10. You're watching the NBA playoffs on NBC. Very nice, guys.
Yes.
Επειδή το καλοκαίρι σας αρέσει να χαλαρώνετε, εμείς τρέχουμε περισσότερο. I got it here. Wow. I feel good. Το καλοκαίρι είναι πιο συναρπαστικό με Super Sport.
They got it up. They were running. They weren't set up where Iverson, they could lock in on him. Everything was on the move with him.
They're running at Toronto, not right. Toronto's walking, and Toronto can't play a walk-up.
Yeah.
Here at the First Union Center, they're going to have to enlarge the trophy case as they've already got the MVP, the sixth man with Aaron McKee, and the defensive player of the year, Dikembe Mutombo, who showed us why in that first quarter.
At the urging of Larry Brown, Dikembe Mutombo has come out and become a defender at the 18-foot range, coming over, denying guard penetration, still allowing himself with fantastic footwork to get back out and get a piece of that shot. The range, the length of Dikembe Mutombo having a huge effect on this game early on.
There you see the numbers from the Stars and the big free throw disparity, which has happened throughout this series. Childs, Carter, Del Curry, Antonio Davis, and Jerome Williams out there for the Raptors.
Vince Carter, more post-up opportunity.
Childs, open jumper, puts it in. And Chris Childs now hit two straight shots.
Well, Chris Childs, a big game player. Now, remember in that New York-Miami series when you're in the fourth quarter, he came through and willed his team to victory. So he's a guy who's capable of having big games under pressure.
Iverson, that's a three. Won't go. Mutombo kicks it to himself beautifully. And then lost it off his leg.
One of the few times Toronto's been able to slow down the fast break. Then they give up an offensive rebound.
Curry throws it away.
Yeah.
Bill, I was waiting for you to talk to Mutombo. Bringing the ball down below the waist as a big man. I hear you talk about that all the time.
Triple threat position, bring it right in. And when you get an offensive rebound, if you don't have an immediate stick back, kick it out to somebody and reset, punish the defense.
Opening minute here in the second quarter of game seven. Iverson off the mark. Williams the rebound.
See, I don't like those last two shots by Allen Iverson. I think that plays into the hands of the Toronto Raptors. When he's driving that ball and creating problems, help his teammates.
Curry able to put it in. Del Curry with that smooth jumper, his first field goal. Iverson is off to a 3-for-10 start from the field.
Kevin Ollie, these bench guys in now, they have got to give this Sixer team a little help with the injuries to George Lynch and all. These guys have got to give them some productive minutes.
The high scoring first quarter, unusual for Philadelphia, that high scoring. Toronto, a little bit better start here to get the second quarter underway.
Mutombo, pretty move, just couldn't finish. And the Raptors with the ball down six. Curry again, the quick release.
Now that's a shot.
He's in there for one reason, to shoot the basketball. He comes off the screen by Carter. And when he comes off Carter's screen, Carter's man is not going to help. And all he needs is just a touch of daylight to get that shot off.
But what a perfect place for Del Curry to play. With a great guy that gets double-teamed, Vince Carter. With fantastic screeners in Antonio Davis and Charles Oakley.
Iverson misses that ball, tipped out though. And they'll get a new 24. Iverson stripped down low. Jermaine Jones comes up with it. Tough shot, won't go. Mutombo, and he draws the foul. Very physical play starting here in the second quarter.
But when the play is breaking down, Toronto is slowly, ever so slowly, getting inched underneath their defensive backboard. The kind of play that Del Curry has to pick up. Then Vince Carter intimidates with a phenomenal leap. Then, when Mutombo finally does get it at point-blank range, all they can do is foul.
Mutombo misses the first. Dikembe Mutombo, of course, played for Lenny Wilkins in Atlanta, but he hasn't made contact with Wilkins since game one. He doesn't want to talk to him. In fact, he's afraid to make eye contact. He told us yesterday that he just kind of averts his eyes. He has so much respect for Wilkins, not only as a coach, but as a good friend, that he doesn't even want to look over at him. He feels sometimes he loses his edge when he does that.
Well, there was an entire era of basketball when you never even acknowledged the existence of the other team.
Now everybody hugs each other. Davis, Antonio Davis with a strong move, and the Raptors suddenly within two, an 8-0 start here in the second quarter.
Well, they're getting some movement and some penetration rather than going east to west. They're getting some north-south basketball now. Now you get some opportunities to get to that basket.
And no transition opportunities for Iverson and the Sixers this entire quarter.
Jermaine Jones, Davis right in his face, and Jones puts it in.
Jermaine Jones is going to have to make that shot because Jerome Williams is going to be the trapper now. Anytime he gets a chance, he's going to run at Iverson with that energy and force him to pass the ball.
Every time Iverson holds the ball, holds it like Carter's doing right here, the double team comes. If you just receive and go right away, make it much more difficult on the defense.
Good ball movement. Three on the shot clock. Childs able to put it in. Chris Childs continuing his terrific play off the bench.
Now you hit a couple jumpers. You spread the floor. Now you can drive that ball to the basket. That's what you have to do.
Not a game to look for the referees to bail you out.
Raptors have certainly showed a lot of character this postseason, winning game five at Madison Square Garden in the first round, winning game one here in Philly in the second round, and they force another turnover. Curry for three.
After he made the first two, he almost has to shoot that one. Nice offense. Allen Iverson again. Jermaine Jones pounding up and down. The fresh legs.
Iverson now with seven assists here in the first half. And the Sixer lead back up to four with 4 minutes gone by in the second. McKee is really working hard on Carter. And Davis off the mark. The tumble, the rebound. Jerome Williams tried to grab it from him. And it pitches separate everyone.
The Raptors have made a big push here to get back in this game, only trailed by four. Del Curry has made a significant contribution off the bench. Defensively, Jerome Williams and Antonio Davis have come alive.
Williams picks up that personal foul, a loose ball foul. Antonio Davis trying to chat with Eddie F. Rush. But a timeout on the floor as after the strong start from the Sixers, answered back by the Raptors. Four and a half gone by, second quarter. Philly by four. That was actually pretty funny, Rico.
Hey, you!
What?
The formula. Where is the formula?
If he's got it.
Have you got the formula, then?
Οι άντρες υδρώνουν 50% περισσότερο από τις γυναίκες. Τώρα η νέα φόρμουλα Rexona for Men με μικρομεταλλικά στοιχεία δίνει τη λύση. Νέο αποσμητικό Rexona for Men. Αξεπέραστη προστασία από τον υδρότα. 100% για άντρες.
Επειδή το καλοκαίρι σας αρέσει να αλλάζετε ρυθμούς, εμείς σας προτείνουμε την ταχύτητα. Η πιο γρήγορη οδηγή του πλανήτη στις πιο δύσκολες διαδρομές. Τα πιο γρήγορα σερβί στον κόσμο. Τα ταχύτερα center fort της Λατινικής Αμερικής. Το καλοκαίρι σπάστε όλα τα ρεκόρ ταχύτητας μόνο στο Supersport. Η πρώτη θέση της κανονικής περιόδου είναι το μεγάλο στοίχημα για Περιστέρι και Παναθηναϊκό στο συγκλονιστικό φινάλε της Τετάρτης. Το γηπεδούχο Περιστέρι θέλει νίκη με διαφορά 10 πόντων, ενώ στον Παναθηναϊκό αρκεί να προστατεύσει τη διαφορά των 9 πόντων με την οποία κέρδισε στον αγώνα του πρώτου γύρου. Δείτε αυτή την Τετάρτη Περιστέρι Παναθηναϊκό. Ζωντανά και αποκλειστικά από το Super Sport.
Πρώτη φορά νιώθεις τόσο μέσα στο παιχνίδι. Supersport.gr. Κάνε παιχνίδι.
Επειδή το καλοκαίρι θέλετε να κάνετε διακοπές, εμείς δεν κάνουμε ποτέ.
think?
Το καλοκαίρι είναι πιο μαγικό με Φίλνετ.
Down by 13 early, now within four. Dart, what's been the difference? How they get back into it?
Well, they forced Philadelphia to miss some shots. You see, only 2 of 7. They took quick shots, and that plays into the hands of Toronto. And then Toronto started aggressively attacking the basket. Del Curry comes in, hits a quick release jumper off the screen by Vince Carter. And then here's the penetration. Look at all the white jerseys. There's Antonio Davis, the shot blocker, out of the picture. He goes right to the rim. We've seen Chris Childs hit a couple jumpers. He takes the ball right at Mutombo. What do? You go into the body of a shot blocker so he can't jump. So they now have gotten into an offensive rhythm. And let's go over to Andrea Joyce. Andrea?
All right, Doug, you mentioned the penetration of Toronto. Well, since the beginning of the second quarter, Lenny Wilkins has been urging his team to be patient, let the play develop, stay steady, and don't settle for those outside shots. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Andrea. Jermaine Jones once again, of course. Larry Brown said they would not have won game two without him. He had 9 points, 5 rebounds in game two. Had 9 more points in game five. He has really stepped up, especially without George Lynch.
And now he'll be called on to play virtually the entire rest of the playoffs for Philadelphia. But Philadelphia's strength is not set offense. Their game is scramble. Their game is get on the offensive board. And then when it all breaks down, give it to Allen Iverson.
Carter fouled. Of course, the Raptors want to make sure Jermaine Jones rest of the playoffs is only about three quarters. Todd McCullough will come in.
When you are playing against a guy like Jerome Williams who's going to go chase the ball, you've got to go to the offensive boards. And Jerome Williams meets his match there with an energy of Jermaine Jones. Second shots, easy scores. And again, if Iverson takes 30 shots, they can still win with him making 10 of them, Bill, because if they'll get to the offensive rebounding, they'll get second chance points, they'll get to the foul line. So to me, it's important for him to get his shot attempts. He's only 3 of 12, but his team is still winning by 6 because they're getting the extra shots at the basket.
As we've done the Philadelphia games over the course of the season, the opponents always try to make him read and think as opposed to just react and flow, that they can get him to take 30 shots or more and 15 or 17 free throws. A lot of teams think they've done a good job.
Iverson wheeling and dealing inside. Doesn't get the bounce and Oakley the rebound. Jerome Williams running the floor. Not a good pass for Chris Childs. And a bad turnover. Childs admits the mistake.
Not in game 7 on the road, down 5. You know, you got to make the simple play. You can't, the spectacular will not get it done today.
I think ball movement for Philadelphia will really expose some of the tendencies defensively of a Del Curry, of a Jerome Williams, and a Vince Carter. Guys who like to play the spectacular defense, maybe not so much the disciplined defense.
Childs does a good job on Snow, and Snow with a terrific shot. He's 3 for 3 from the field. Sixers back up by 7. Toronto had gotten within 2 at one point. Carter inside does not get the roll. See Rodney Buford in the game for Philly. Snow. Jones on the tip-in. Jermaine Jones. 8 points here in the second quarter.
And Lenny Wilkins has seen enough. Somebody please get a rebound.
When you drive the ball to the basket, you're taught as a defender to react to the penetration. Jermaine Jones goes to the front of the rim as Jerome Williams helps on the penetration. That's two offensive rebounds. See, there's Jerome Williams. His man is Jermaine Jones. Two straight tip-ins. Those are game-winning kind of plays in a game seven when you're finding ways to try to score.
Game over.
Το Rally Acropolis τρέχει στο Super Sport. Του Σακυλονίου, κοντρά στους δίδυμους πύργους του Σαν Αντώνιο, Τιμ Ντάνκαν και Ντέιβιντ Ρόμπινσον. Η τελική της Δύσης στο NBA συγκλονίζουν και κόβουν την ανάσα. Ποιος θα πάει στους τελικούς του NBA, οι πρωταθλητές του 99 Spurs ή οι περσινοί θριαμβευτές Lakers? Δείτε τα ξημερώματα του Σαββάτου, τον τρίτο τελικό της Δύσης, Lakers Σαν Αντώνιο. Βλέπετε NBA, ζωντανά και αποκλειστικά, από το Super Sport.
Επειδή είστε εθισμένοι στα σπορ, αυτό το καλοκαίρι μπήκαμε στο μυαλό σας. Εμείς σας προσφέρουμε το πάθος και την ένταση των μεγάλων τελικών. Τελική Α1 μπάσκετ. Τελική NBA. Τελική Wimbledon. Τελικός Copa America. Αυτό το καλοκαίρι οι μεγάλοι τελικοί παίζουν μόνο στο Super Sport.
Do we know how many of these were road teams that won?
This was a home team. The Houston game was a road game. Okay.
Point lead for the Sixers just past the midway point of the second. What a fun day for the NBA fans. So a game seven in Milwaukee as the Bucks advance. It's only the fourth time in NBA history that two game sevens have been played on the same day, as you see in 94, 92, and 81. And congratulations to the Bucks for advancing.
You must have played in this game at the bottom, Doug. This is Philadelphia and Milwaukee. Weren't you there in 81?
Yes, but interesting enough, you want to talk about how important it is to have the home court advantage. Only Kansas City in 81 won as a road team. We've already seen Milwaukee win today at home, the seventh deciding game. That's why you play all season long, to have a better record so you can get that game in your building.
Of course, the winner of this one will face the Bucks. If Philadelphia wins game one, would be in Philly, but if Toronto wins game one, would be in Milwaukee. And a foul called on Buford in trying to deny the ball on Carter.
One of the problems that Toronto is facing is that they got off to a slow start and then came back. I think it fell behind and then came back. Fell behind and then came back. And when you're always battling off that crowd, it just takes so much. By the end of the game, you have nothing left for that last push.
That foul is second team foul. Carter dishes to Alvin Williams. Williams can't connect. Carter fighting inside, and a loose ball foul is going to go against the Sixers. And Jermaine Jones, that'll be his first.
But watching Vince Carter getting to work on the offensive glass, knowing his desperation time for his team, the ball out of his hands, making a contribution in so many ways, and the footwork battle away from the ball by passing by Davis.
Oakley wide open, and he blows the layup.
Oh, he had his left eye on Mutombo. Charles saw the shot blocker coming and lost the concentration.
The presence of Dikembe Mutombo. Iverson, Childs right on top of him. Excellent defense. Oakley the rebound.
Allen Iverson has missed his last seven shots, and no one's more frustrated than he is, pumping his arms, saying, gosh, make one.
Iverson, though, with eight assists in the game here in the first half. Iverson upset with the foul call, but he picks up the personal. That's his first, and the 14 foul against Philly.
Charles Oakley, a wide open layup and some exquisite ball movement. But Mutombo was in a different zip code.
But you know as well as I do, Bill, when you're a shot blocker, just the idea that you're around, especially with Oakley, who doesn't have great lift to finish around the basket.
Giles, the ball fake, but then comes up way short. Raptors have missed their last six shots from the field. Oh, threads the needle to Jones, and he's fouled. Aaron McKee with a perfect pass between several defenders.
When you're playing in these games, you have a mindset of run, run, and never stop. That's what Jermaine Jones has brought today. He is up and down, capitalizing on the fact that Oakley doesn't want to run with him. Jerome Williams always wants to go around and steal the ball from somebody else.
Alvin Williams, his second foul. Jones misses the first. Coming up at halftime, we'll bring you exclusive coverage of the NBA draft lottery. Who'll get the top pick? The Bulls, the Warriors, the Wizards have the best chances. The 13 teams in the running for the top spot. The NBA draft lottery coming up at halftime. And I guess we're not going to be able to talk to you at halftime, Doug. Huh?
I'll be busy.
Who are you taking?
I'm taking the Wizards. You know who I'm taking.
No. Who are you drafting?
I don't know, Bill. Let me get that first pick first, and I'll tell you.
I want to know who your starting lineup is going to be next year.
Jones misses both free throws. Davis, the line drive jumper. And boy, has he improved on his shot. Over the years, he's become a very solid shooter from the outside.
And playing with a very sore triceps muscle in that left arm, really battling through a very tough time, tells you how much he wants to win here today.
He's got 10 points and four boards already. Jones drives out Oakley. Oakley with the terrific defensive play. Six turnovers for Philadelphia.
Beautiful soft layout outlet pass by Charles Oakley that time.
Davis gets away from Mutombo. Again, the good ball movement. Davis again puts it in. Antonio Davis now 6 of 9 from the field.
All five guys touched the ball in that possession. Went from side to side back to the original player who knocked it down. That's great passing.
He looked like he was limping a little bit there running up the floor.
But that was Toronto Raptor basketball. The ball movement, knocked down perimeter shots, capitalizing the fact that they're going to have to double team Vince Carter.
McKee for three. Aaron McKee from downtown. And the Sixers lead back up to 8.
I've always felt the end of quarters, the end of halves are vital times. Right now, it's an 8-point game. The Raptors, this next 3 minutes, have got to try to cut into this lead. They cannot allow the Sixers to push this into double digits.
Well, Allen Iverson has had the support today of guys like Snow, Aaron McKee, Mutombo, Jermaine Jones. Vince Carter been out there isolated a lot. Alvin Williams has been quiet.
Williams still without a field goal. Carter flips it up. Won't go on the tip. Mutombo trying to knock it loose. And the ball goes into the hands of Alvin Williams.
We saw Kobe Bryant yesterday at the offensive glass. We're seeing the same determined effort from Vince Carter this evening.
He has 4 rebounds, but he has several others that he's kept alive. And a whistle. Illegal defense call. That's the first against Philly. So a warning, and we'll take a break. A terrific pace to this game. 7 from Philadelphia. Sixers 8-point lead. 2.5 left. First half.
Επειδή το καλοκαίρι σας αρέσει να χαλαρώνετε, εμείς τρέχουμε περισσότερο.
Το
καλοκαίρι είναι πιο συναρπαστικό με Super Sport.
Already, Doug.
What's that?
I think you knew those odds already.
I knew that. Yeah. Thanks a lot for reminding me that.
Meanwhile, the Sixer defense.
But I've got a method for Ahmad, because he's got one of these commercials out there right now, and he talks about tall players. And on behalf of all tall people out there, I object to his use of the word lumber.
Iverson off the turnover.
Iverson missed 9 straight shots, and you give him a layup to push the lead to 10. As a coach, you just pull your hair out or go gray, but you can't do that.
And the Sixer defense again, that's the 7th turnover. Oakley steps back, comes up short, fight for the rebound. Last touch by Antonio Davis.
Allen Iverson, so quick to the ball, the anticipation. He's pressuring the guy who threw the ball in. But then it was Aaron McKee and Eric Snow popping that ball away. Transition opportunity to all Philadelphia.
Under 2 minutes remaining in the first half. Mutombo does not get the roll. Ball knocked nearly out of bounds, but Oakley saves it. A lot of contact on that play.
Dial a violation. Both directions.
It did look a bit awkward. And as a foul down low, it's going to go against Tyrone Hill. That's 3 fouls on Hill, and the Sixers in the penalty, so Oakley will go to the line.
And that's a huge problem, because without George Lynch, who plays so many different positions, now Larry Brown comes quickly back with Jermaine Jones, who has made a significant contribution here. Matt Geiger is out, unable to play due to a very sore knee. 3 serious knee operations in 15 months for Matt Geiger.
Jones back in, Oakley to the line.
The one thing you can get away, Jermaine Jones is an undersized power forward. Oakley's not going to post you up. So you can get away with a smaller lineup in a game like this.
But this is also where Mutombo can be so valuable. You got a guy who controls the whole basket area. And great big men, they like to play with the smaller guys, because then that spreads the floor and lets them play their game, gets a transition opportunities.
Mutombo with 9 rebounds. He only has 1 block shot, but he's altered several others. As Oakley hits the 2nd free throw, Oakley with 6 points. 8-point Philly lead, minute and a half left, 2nd quarter. Iverson the floater. Oh, pretty shot from Allen Iverson.
Well, the hesitation, he comes in, looks like he's going to spin back for his patented turnaround, but then just turns it on once again. Acceleration.
13 points, 8 assists for Iverson. Sixers have led by as many as 13. Raptors came back and pulled within 2 at one point, but now they're down double digits again. Bad pass from Oakley, but it was tipped. So it's not a backcourt violation. The ball was tipped, but the shot clock's winding down, and there's a 24-second violation.
Larry Brown has to be ecstatic, and Lenny Wilkins can only shake his head. The turnovers, the carelessness for Toronto, feeding the frenzy here in Philadelphia.
They have 8 turnovers. As we said, they had 8 total turnovers in game 6. And in the game 5 that they lost here, they had 10 in the first quarter that really hurt them.
I just think it's when you go in on a downer at half, when you have 3 or 4 possessions at the end of a half and you don't execute, you turn the ball over, you get some shots, you got to go in for 15 minutes and sit through that. I just think it's so vital to finish quarters and halves in a positive way.
2-for-1 time, Philadelphia. Shoot at 40, get the last one.
Aaron McKee puts it in. McKee with 13 points.
You can see why he was the 6th man of the year. Now as a starter, he's just such a terrific player.
And the Raptors will use their 22nd timeout. McKee's feed was from Iverson, who now has 9 assists. The 2 starting guards for the Sixers really putting on a show.
Allen Iverson, 2 possessions ago. The hesitation, the jump start once again, igniting his teammates, inspiring greatness in others.
Yes.
And the ball.
Okay.
Oh, okay. 40 seconds.
Thanks.
There's the Wizards' first pick. Sixers back up by 12. And you said that comment, Doug, with a little over 3 minutes to go, the importance of finishing strong, and it's just been the opposite for Lenny Wilkins's club.
You know, I've seen this with Toronto in this series where they have had leads or they've been behind and they have not finished quarters well. Even with leads, they've allowed Philadelphia back in the game. What they've allowed here, Bill, is Philadelphia to push this to a double-digit lead. Now, if Philadelphia gets a stop here and scores, that would be big.
Fighting from behind again has been a thing that's plagued Toronto throughout the evening. They've had very little determined offense here. Davis flips it up and gets the nice roll. And they just checked their clock. Danny Crawford checking to make sure the right time left on the clock.
5 second differential, so what they've done with the shot clock now. It looked like it was a 29-4. Now they're running it down, so we'll have to see what's going on here.
Some of the fans yelling delay of game. It's a second one, but it wasn't a delay of game call. They're just checking on the clock.
Well, they get it now. It's almost a 6 second differential. So if Toronto gets a stop here and a score, now remember, Toronto has a foul to give. So if Iverson beats it, they'll want to take the foul.
Iverson, just keep the ball here. Keep it to the last possible moment. They'll come. Iverson looking up at the shot clock, now makes his move. Williams playing him well. Iverson drives in, off balance. Won't go, Mutombo's tip. Oakley the rebound, still 5 seconds left. Carter releases, fouled by McKee. And Carter will shoot two as Aaron McKee picks up his second.
What a play by Charles Oakley. And he started the game playing well with a couple of jumpers and tried to quiet this frenzied crowd here. Then the long outlet over the top of the oncoming Mutombo. Perfect stride, and Vince Carter finally a trip to the line.
Oakley has thrown some of those passes behind his back at some point in his career. He loves the fancy long pass. Carter hits the first. Memorial Day weekend. The NBA playoffs continue on NBC. Four big conference finals games. All the holiday action tips off Friday night at 9 Eastern in primetime. Doug, you'll be there as Tim Duncan and the Spurs. Try and even things up with Shaq and the Lakers. Obviously, that'll be game three, so we'll see what the series is then. And then the Spurs and the Lakers Friday at 9 Eastern, post game Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, all here on NBC.
Don't you think David Robinson has to play more than 30 minutes?
I agree. Yesterday, Bill, they were up 5, and when they took him out, the Lakers were on a 15-3 run. They never were able to recover.
2.3 seconds remaining. Jones catches, and a foul. They had a foul to give. Smart play by Del Curry. That's a veteran knowing the situation. Jermaine Jones is trying to say he was shooting.
Now, Danny Crawford said, what were you going to do, throw it over your shoulder? You were heading to the other basket.
You haven't seen him play enough.
So a 20-second timeout called by the Sixers. They'll inbound with 1.4 remaining in the first half.
Yeah. Look at Jermaine Jones is heading towards half court.
He was shooting.
Yeah, right.
I played with guys like that.
Jermaine Jones, 10 points in the first half, but he wanted it all on this last play.
50 feet away from the hoop, running with his back straight to the hoop. The turnaround jumper.
The turnaround jumper from 45.
Well, you know, Bill, you and I both played with World Be Free. That would have been a shot right there. That would have been three-shot foul.
That would have been right in World's rhythm.
McKee gets it off the time, but it comes up short. And that will end the first half. As Allen Iverson does not shoot the ball well, just 5 of 17. But Iverson with 9 assists, and he did finish with 13 points. Meanwhile, Vince Carter, fresh off his graduation, at 11 points. He had 4 assists of his own.
Game 7 from Philadelphia. Halftime here at the First Union Center. Sixers an 8-point advantage. Coming up after these messages, our exclusive halftime coverage of the 2001 NBA Draft Lottery. You're watching the NBA playoffs on NBC.
Επειδή το καλοκαίρι σας αρέσει να αλλάζετε ρυθμούς, εμείς σας προτείνουμε την ταχύτητα. Η πιο γρήγορη οδική του πλανήτη στις πιο δύσκολες διαδρομές. Τα πιο γρήγορα σερβί στον κόσμο. Τα ταχύτερα center court της Λατινικής Αμερικής. Το καλοκαίρι σπάστε όλα τα ρεκόρ ταχύτητας μόνο στο Super Sport. Η Δήμητρα Παπαδοπούλου στο VIP. Η γνωστή ηθοποιός μιλάει στο Γιώργο Παπαχρήστο για τη μεγάλη της επιτυχίας «Αγαπώ μ' αγαπάς», για το θέατρο και τα παράξενα της καθημερινής μας ζωής. VIP. Η άλλη πλευρά των ανθρώπων της πρώτης σελίδας. Ποιος είναι ο εικονιζόμενος ποδοσφαιριστής? Επισκεφτείτε το supersport.gr. Πάρτε μέρος κάθε εβδομάδα στο Sony Vega Photo Quiz και κερδίστε δώρα από τη Sony Vega. Αποκλειστικά στο supersport.gr. Κάνε παιχνίδι.
Τώρα η Nova είναι για όλους. Γιατί τώρα, με το χρηματοδοτικό πρόγραμμα Nova Easy, μπορείτε να αποκτήσετε τον εξοπλισμό της Nova με 49.000 προκαταβολή. Και τα υπόλοιπα με 4.900 το μήνα άτοκα. Μη στέκεστε εκεί. Γίνετε συνδρομητής τώρα. Με Nova Easy είναι τόσο εύκολο. Nova. Τα πάντα είναι στο χέρι σου.
Βλέπετε Super Sport.
Yeah, and then I'll talk Toronto. And they got Philadelphia got 10 points off turnovers.
Are they throwing it back to us?
Time of game 7 from Philadelphia. 76ers with an 8-point lead. Allen Iverson playing the role of distributor. Meanwhile, Antonio Davis and Vince Carter needing some help in the second half for the Toronto Raptors. And hello again, everyone, along with Bill Walton and a very happy Doug Collins, owner of a number one pick, Mike Breen on hand here. And Bill, let's start with Philadelphia and Allen Iverson. Not shooting the ball well, but he's had an enormous impact.
The ball is in his hands, and that's the world that Allen Iverson needs to keep living in. All the role players have contributed significantly. Jermaine Jones, Aaron McKee, and Eric Snow have done a terrific job. The 9 assists for Allen Iverson. The give and goes, the back cuts, it's all right there. Philadelphia has dominated all stats, particularly on the offensive glass. And when you look at the way they're playing right now and the superior contributions of Allen Iverson, Vince Carter only getting 10 shot attempts, does have four nice assists, but that's just not enough. The bigger, a bigger question, though, is what they're paying you in Washington. Is that enough to have not only Michael Jordan playing for you, Charles Barkley, Patrick Ewing, and the number one draft pick, and Chris Webber? That's a pretty good starting lineup you've got.
What can I say, Bill?
Congratulations.
The rest is all set.
How about let's talk about Toronto, what they've got to be able to do here. First of all, their perimeter shooting has been bad. Vince Carter, 3 of 10, but Morris Peterson, 0 of 3, Alvin Williams, 0 of 3, so they're 3 of 16. 10 points off turnovers for the 76ers. Antonio Davis, 7 of 10. The rest of the team, 10 of 30. So they have got to get some contributions. And Vince Carter, we talked about in the open, stars on the road in Game 7 have to come to the forefront. He's got to dominate.
So we'll see what Carter does in the second half. Meanwhile, Andrea Joyce spoke with Larry Brown just a short time ago.
All right, thanks, Mike. Coach, first of all, your thoughts on Allen Iverson's play in the first half, the way that he distributed the ball?
I thought he played great. You know, they're doubling him, and he found open people. Some of his shots I thought were a little quick, but, you know, he's trying to win. I admire that. But if they're going to keep doubling him, you know, he's got to try to find people, and we got to get people available.
Game six was a frantic pace. Aaron McKee said it was like a fire drill. What about the pace today?
It's pretty quick. You know, I think they're a team that likes to get up and down the floor, and they kind of make you play at their pace, and we're at home. But it's a little fast for my benefit. But, you know, the big key now is we got to figure out a way to keep Tyrone in the game because we're not very deep.
What did you tell your team at halftime in the locker room?
Well, we just talked about our intensity. You know, we want to leave this game knowing that we played as hard as we could and helped our teammates play better.
Okay.
And hopefully that'll get it done.
All right, thanks. Good luck in the second half. Back to you, Mike.
Andrea, thank you. So Larry Brown with his adjustments. Now, you mentioned Vince Carter, Doug, in terms of he has to step to the forefront, but what are some of the other things that Toronto needs to do in the second half?
They've got to get off to a positive start here in this third period. They dug themselves a hole in the first period. They've got down by 10, and basically that's where they are right now. So they've played uphill. Bill, you talked about it in fits and spurts, and when you're on the road using that kind of energy, will you have enough to finish the game? They need to get off to a very positive start here, and Vince Carter's got to lead them.
And for Philadelphia, Allen Iverson, this is his time. This is MVP time. The referees are not going to call a thing. You got to come out and say, I'm up and down this court. I want that ball every single time, and I am going to set a pace that no one else can match.
And, of course, we talk about Iverson and Carter frequently throughout this series. But how about Aaron McKee? He had 13 points in the first half, and his defense on Carter was excellent.
Larry Brown made a good point, though. Eric Snow is the only guy contributing off the bench. With all the injuries that they have, George Lynch, Matt Geiger, somebody is going to have to play better than they've done. That leaves guys like Kevin Ollie, Rodney Buford, Todd McCullough, who got limited minutes in the first half, but not much in terms of statistical contribution.
I always feel like the first possession coming out of a halftime or a quarter tells you what the coach is thinking. Where do we have to go? How can we get our stars shot? Where can we attack? Let's see what Toronto does on this first possession.
If we know what Philly does, they come right away and press. You want to get running and be warmed up.
See Avid Williams bring the ball up. Williams scoreless. He has had such a terrific playoffs. Davis.
Extended defense by Philadelphia up against the shot clock.
Williams on a pull-up. There it is. Alvin Williams, a Philly native, who has felt some pressure playing here, and certainly guarding Allen Iverson, finally gets on the board.
Yeah, 0 for 3. We talked about it at halftime, but he is the fourth quarter guy. Interesting. He's Mr. Clutch for this team.
Nearly 40% of his points during the regular season coming in the fourth quarter. Gets some here on the third. McKee. Oh, Aaron McKee, pretty creative of his own shot.
I like the discipline that McKee has offensively and the Eric Snow. They're always squared up. They never have to force anything. They've got the ultimate force in Allen Iverson.
Guys, now that he's won the Sixth Man Award, can you still say he's one of the more underrated players in the league, or is that out?
I think that's out.
Oakley, that's a three. Charles Oakley from downtown
for three.
This is the way he started the game. Remember hitting those little jump shots. That time he steps out. I didn't know Oak had that kind of range now.
Oakley in this series, 3 of 4 from that distance. And the lead just like that cut to 5. And Philly led by as many as 13 in the first half. Iverson turns it over. Antonio Davis, one man to beat. Jones fouls him. And Davis will shoot two.
When you're in transition defense, your mind has to immediately go to the fact that, look, we don't have any reserves on the bench. Jermaine Jones who only had one foul in the first half, that's the kind of play you just let go.
I think, Bill, what's happened now, you've seen Toronto come out. They've got off to a very positive start. Oakley hits a three. Alvin Williams hits his first basket of the game. They get a steal, run out, a possible couple free throws here, and all of a sudden that lead could be cut down to three, and we've only played about a minute and a half.
Davis misfires. A reminder, coming up tomorrow night on TNT, game two, Lakers and the Spurs from the Alamo Dome. Lakers so impressive in game one. Spurs certainly cannot afford to go down 0-2 in that series, though.
I expect Tim Duncan to come back and play much better. You know, Bill is a big guy. When you see all those double teams, you get to watch it on tape a little bit, find out where maybe you can find some openings. The Lakers smothered him yesterday, and he got not much help from anybody else.
Don't negate the contributions of Horace Grant and Robert Horry. Just terrific, terrific job.
Meanwhile, the contributions of Antonio Davis continues. He has 15 points to lead the Raptors. Mutombo deep this time in the post and able to knock it down. Just his second field goal, but he's had a big impact in this game.
You've got to get on his left shoulder and make him turn the other way. I don't know the Bill that he can even turn that way.
Have you ever seen him shoot the turn and jumper off the board?
He can't turn that way. I'm telling you, you got to get on that left shoulder.
Morris Peterson puts it in, and Peterson gets his first field goal. Very good signs for the Raptors.
Absolutely. Alvin Williams and Peterson now both in the flow of the game.
Well, neither one of them scored in the first half.
And the Raptors, throughout the playoffs, there have been games you think that they're struggling, but they have shown so much character as Oakley comes up with a steal. And it's knocked out of bounds.
Well, they're calling
Toronto ball.
Well, they're not calling a foul. Looked like that they're whistled Iverson here.
They did, Bill.
They called the foul here. Beautiful step out by Charles Oakley. All ball. And then Iverson with the shoulder takedown. Oakley, he needs to be able to continue these contributions. It's a great start to the game. Great start to the third quarter. He's got to be there for the final 20 minutes.
Over the last 10 years, Oakley, one of the premier help defenders in the NBA. Peterson again, able to put it in.
We're looking at a completely different Toronto team. Lenny Wilkins obviously hitting all the right buttons.
Remember Peterson coming out in the fourth quarter of game six, hit those two huge threes when Philly got back in the game. Now he hits two big shots here to start the third.
Question is now, does Allen Iverson try to do too much, or does he do that? Penetrate and find one of his teammates. You know, Allen Iverson wants to win so badly, he's got to make sure when he gets all those defenders that he trusts his teammate.
He has just tied his playoff career high in assists. That's his 10th assist of the game, and we're early in the third. Carter puts it in.
Carter saw the double team coming one way. Jed took Tyrone Hill apart right there, went away from it, pull-up jumper.
Raptors 5 for 5 from the field. Here to start the third.
Toronto's extended their defense as well.
Nice ball fake from Iverson. He gets hit hard as he goes down. Mutombo blocked from behind by Davis. Mutombo gets it again. And a foul call on Antonio Davis.
Everybody standing in reach, and the only one on the floor was Charles Oakley. When that ball is down there, you got to get down yourself.
Look at Allen Iverson holding that left hip. Took a nasty fall as he drove to the basket, but again, his misses are like assists because he draws so many people. The Sixers have inside position. Two efforts by Mutombo, and he finally gets to the line. Now, the big part about this is Mutombo is an excellent free throw shooter for a big man, so you like for him to get to the line.
It's beautiful when Allen comes down that lane, though. He rarely gets his shot blocked. And as a guard trying to create in the lane, you just want to throw it up over the top. Throw it up soft, because as people are lunging at you, that's going to create lanes for your teammates to come in and just read it so perfectly for the throwdown.
The foul on Davis is second. Iverson's so shaken up. One of the most remarkable things about his season is how banged up he has played. Lenny Currier, the longtime veteran trainer for Philadelphia, he says that Iverson's pain threshold is off the charts, like he's never seen on another player.
But we haven't seen this. I mean, the look on his face right now, one of severe pain.
Oakley, there's that behind the back pass. Carter comes up short. Mutombo with his 13th rebound.
Mutombo, who has never advanced past the second round. told us before the game how important this is for his career.
Otumbo, of course, is the latest pro athlete to give that meaningless guarantee prior to the game. And a three-second violation. As Eric Snow said, what is a guy supposed to say? Oh, we're going to lose game seven?
Larry Brown, irate with the call, 3 seconds. With Allen Iverson down the lane, the fall, he lands right on his backside. And he's been holding it and grimacing ever since.
4 point Philly lead. We played 4.5 minutes into the third. Snow is now on Carter.
Finally, some post-up opportunities for Carter.
The double team forces the turnover, but Peterson gets it back. And a jump ball. Peterson was looking to try and call a timeout, but never really had the handle.
He was calling timeout before he had the ball.
And in some ways, sometimes that's a blessing. You don't want to give away your timeout early.
I know when I was coaching, Bill, one thing I talked about is, you know, that's not a good play in the first quarter, early in the game. You want to save those, especially now you can move the ball on a 20-second timeout. Makes it much more vital.
Oh, that was so in.
Now halfway down, but they get a second opportunity. Oakley, second thoughts there. Alvin Williams off the mark to Tyrone Hill with a rebound.
Who can run with Iverson?
Good defense from Williams. These two are friends, Alvin Williams and Iverson. They play a lot during the summer. Snow. And Antonio Davis with another rebound. Well,
Morris Peterson has made huge contributions throughout this second half.
Alvin Williams really didn't have good balance, but able to put it in.
Well, you know that Lenny Wilkins at halftime told Alvin Williams and Morris Peterson, guys, you've got to get active. That's going to help Vince get involved in the game so they can't pay so much attention to him.
So again, the Raptors within two. But Iverson puts it back to four.
The movement without the ball.
Oh, he's really hurting.
Who can get shots? A lot of guys can knock down open shots, but who should be able to create shots? It is Philadelphia's fine ball movement, creating easy opportunities for Iverson.
Carter with Hill on him, looking for Oakley. But again, Oakley not a post-up player, even though he has McKee on him. And there's your turnover. Iverson running the floor. And the Sixers go back up by six.
Got to be Vince Carter time right now.
Vince Carter was too unselfish on that last play. Oakley's not a post player. Tyrone Hill is playing him. Wave Oakley out of there and you take Tyrone Hill.
And Allen Iverson obviously shaken up.
That's what I'm talking about. He goes inside because of the screen and the mismatch. Mutombo comes over and helps. That's where Vince Carter's got to say, look, I'm the star, Oak. You rebound my miss. I'm going to attack. But do we have that play? Can you show me that play? Well, I'll show you what happens. When they switch where...
Επειδή το καλοκαίρι σας αρέσει να χαλαρώνετε, εμείς τρέχουμε περισσότερο.
Καλοκαίρι είναι πιο συναρπαστικό με Super Sport.
The Oscar Collection.
βραβευμένα τραγούδια και μουσικά θέματα σε ένα διπλό CD. Ανακαλύψτε τη μαγεία των Όσκαρ. The Oscar Collection. Μια διαχρονική συλλογή που έχει πάρει Όσκαρ. Σε όλα τα καταστήματα δίσκων ή με αντικαταβολή στο 6602-339.
Okay. And Mike, you can lead me in.
Charles Oakley always compares himself to a boxer who wears his opponents down in a basketball game, needs a cut man on the bench. Meanwhile, Oakley involved in a play. Doug, to bring back your point, Vince Carter needs to take control. He didn't hear.
Look what's happened now. They're going to come off the screen. Vince Carter's going to come off the screen, and they're going to switch the play, and we'll roll it forward, and we get a chance to look at it. Here he comes. Now as he catches it, look right here. Oakley said, you get out, Oak, and you let him attack Tyrone Hill. That's the matchup you want. Instead, Oakley holds the post. Vince Carter gives up the ball. Now what happens? Oak gets inside. Little help. They kick the ball loose. And who ends up with the score? Allen Iverson on the other end laying the ball in the basket.
And Oakley does so many things well, but that's not his strength, is posting up.
Doug, you made a comment yesterday in the game about Kobe Bryant. He said, greatness is greedy.
Absolutely.
That's what Vince Carter needs right now.
The jumper is good from Antonio Davis. Now, Carter has shown that, certainly as the playoffs have gone on. Last year in the first round loss to the Knicks, he struggled early on, of course, went through a whole thing where Oakley got on him to be the man. But he has to continue that here, certainly in the second half.
Hopefully he's saying something in the huddle.
Iverson, the key, nice little ball fake, comes up short however, and a loose ball foul call on Dikembe Mutombo. Mutombo picks up his first, and let's go to Andrea Joyce.
All right, Mike, Larry Brown just told me in that timeout that Iverson hurt his tailbone. Now, trainer Lenny Currier was icing his left tailbone there, Iverson's, during the timeout. They will continue to do that anytime he's on the bench. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Andrea. Well, he has played through so many different things throughout the course of the season. Alvin Williams again. Well, that's his third field goal here in the third quarter.
Toronto is playing so great on offense right now. All their shots are going in. Their ball movement is much quicker and sharper. They're rebounding.
Bill, the Raptors really showing poise. They've gotten down to double digits several times. Five on the shot clock. Eric Snow off the mark. Mutombo taken away by Morris Peterson.
Toronto's defense has got Eric Snow and Aaron McKee trying to beat them off the dribble, and that's not their game. That's Iverson's game.
Now here's Peterson's got a mismatch. He can attack. He decides to give it up, and they're going inside to Antonio Daniels, Davis, who has the mismatch and throws up a weak shot against the smaller defender.
Davis rushed it. McKee the other way, blows by Peterson and draws the foul. Shot won't go, but Aaron McKee will go to the line as Peterson picks up his second.
So many times when you're in the post and you got a little guy who's scrambling around, and Antonio Davis has got Eric Snow there. He doesn't have any balance. He doesn't have any ability to explode there. With the great charge from the weak side by Tyrone Hill, that took the concentration away from Antonio Davis.
Tyrone Hill, the excellent help defense. And here goes McKee. We've been talking so much about him. One of the nice moments this year for Philadelphia. When Allen Iverson won his MVP at the ceremony, McKee hits the first. Iverson said, this year I tried to emulate Aaron McKee, to become a professional like McKee is day in and day out. They're close friends. Iverson, of course, had the trouble with not going to practice, showing up late. But here's one of his role models, is his teammate, Aaron McKee.
Well, you know, it's interesting, and Bill, and you know this, we talk about it a lot. When your teammates start putting pressure on you, it's a different kind of pressure than when the coach puts it on you. And so when your teammates start telling you, we love your talent, but we need you to be a part of this, that makes a bigger difference. And Allen Iverson has listened to his teammates and his coach.
And we've seen that play out with the Los Angeles Lakers. As that, now it's a love fest with the Lakers.
Alvin Williams, blocked by Iverson. He got a piece of it. The Raptors wanted a goal chance, and McKee comes down the other end, and a loose ball foul called. It's going to go against Antonio Davis, who is red hot.
Allen Iverson, when he was in college, was the two-time Big East Defensive Player of the Year. He races back. That's a great block. That is right at the top.
He got it before it hit the backboard. The last foul on Davis is third.
See, Mike, the thing I love about that play is Iverson turned the ball over, but he didn't quit on the play. He didn't hang his head. He went back and made a better play defensively.
Alvin Williams has done a good job on Iverson here today. Of course, he shot some help. Iverson, a tough shot. Mutombo, the rebound.
Mutombo's been all over the offensive glass.
He's fouled. You can't even hear the whistle. This place is so loud.
What?
When you make the commitment to chase a great player and trap him, that means that three guys are playing four. That means you're going to be able to get to the offensive boards, and that's what Mutombo has done. There's no blockout responsibilities. Basically, you're playing a zone now as a defensive team rather than guarding your man, and Mutombo is an excellent offensive rebounder.
And the way he keeps rolling to that ball, there's no stop. The first rule of rebounding is anticipate every shot to be missed.
Davis, meanwhile, picks up his fourth foul, and Lenny Wilkins right now keeping him in the game with the four fouls, even though there's 3:21 left in just the third quarter. Snow sits down. Kevin Ollie back in.
Well, you know, as a coach, Mike, if this is, can they can keep this game at about 4, 5, or 6? Maybe with about a minute to go, you get Antonio Davis out so that he doesn't get the fourth, but also he gets a little rest and going into the fourth period. But he cannot get his fifth foul right now. That would be deadly for his team.
Well, we haven't seen Keon Clark, who's the one guy off the bench at the front line who can give Lenny Wilkins some offensive punch.
Forrest Peterson again. What a different player here in the third quarter. He's 3 for 3 from the field.
Now, he's a rookie, but he was also a fifth-year senior in college. He went to Michigan State and won an NCAA championship. He's a mature young guy.
He's had some success in elimination games.
And under an incredibly gifted coach, Tom Izzo.
McKee comes up short, and Davis pulls down the rebound. Davis with 17 points and 7 boards.
Antonio Davis is struggling physically, dragging that left arm of his. Whole left side of his body looks to be numb.
Both these teams have really had to deal with injuries. Carter.
Now that's the greediness you were talking about. Just take that ball, put your head down, look everybody else off, and get the bucket and the foul.
He looked like he got away with a travel.
Yes, he did.
No way. That was perfect.
I watch him fake the pass. 1, 2, 3.
That's a great drive.
4 fouls on Tyrone Hill. Carter with a chance for a 3-point play and a chance to give the Raptors their first lead since the first quarter. Hold on a second.
Let's go!
Game over.
Το Rally Ακρόπολη τρέχει στο Super Sport.
Αβάν πρεμιέρ από το Filmed Cine Clubbing με μάγους και δράκοντες. Την Κυριακή 27 Μαΐου στον κινηματογράφο Έριξον Αθηναής 1 και 2. Dungeons and Dragons. Το διάσημο παιχνίδι έγινε μια φανταστική ταινία που έχει τα πάντα. Μάχες και συγκρούσεις. Απρόοπτα και εκπληκτικά εφέ. Μεγάλους πρωταγωνιστές. Μια φανταστική περιπέτεια για όλη την οικογένεια. Από το Filmed Cine Clubbing και την προοπτική. Dungeons and Dragons. Ειδικά και αποκλειστικά για εσάς.
Oh!
είστε εθισμένοι στα σπορ, αυτό το καλοκαίρι μπήκαμε στο μυαλό σας. Εμείς σας προσφέρουμε το πάθος και την ένταση των μεγάλων τελικών. Τελική Α1 μπάσκετ, τελική NBA, τελική Wimbledon, τελικός Copa America. Αυτό το καλοκαίρι οι μεγάλοι τελικοί παίζουν μόνο στο Superstore.
Remaining third quarter, all tied up. Antonio Davis of the Raptors, double-doubles in all but one game. He has been just so superb throughout the entire postseason, including this series, and in such pain, they're being attended to by head trainer Chuck Mooney.
Boy, you can tell he's really hurting, guys. When you look at Antonio Davis's statuesque physique, and this guy is built like no one else. He's just magnificent. And you can see that pain just coming right through his eyes. He won't be out long. That arm just sort of limply hanging.
You see the importance. He picks up his fourth foul, and the Toronto is able to take the lead. This gives Lenny Wilkins a chance to give him a rest, let that arm heal, protect him with the fouls. His team now has the lead.
Well, you see their first lead since the opening minutes. They trailed by as many as 13 in this game. Several times they've been down by double digits, have come back and fallen behind again, but they just don't stop coming at you. Mutombo and Oakley battling down low, and a foul call on Oakley.
How can that be a defensive foul? Charles Oakley's just standing right there.
Well, if you're going to let the offensive player dislodge, you've got to allow the defensive player to be able to fight back. And you see both of these guys fighting for position. And when Mutombo sort of dips that left shoulder, I don't know where Oakley's going to go on that play. I don't know how otherwise you can hold your ground, Bill.
Oakley picks up just his first foul, but again, it's the 15th foul.
That should be a no call, or just a violation of the rules of human decency.
Mutombo misses the first. Antonio Davis, meanwhile, has gone back to the Raptors locker room. Andrea Joyce in pursuit, and we'll get a report as soon as it's available. As you see Jermaine Jones back in the game. Jones had 10 first half points. Tyrone Hill 6. And here's Mutombo's numbers. 8 of the 14 on the offensive end. And he goes 1 of 2 from the line. Tie game as we approach 2 minutes remaining. Third quarter of game 7.
I'd come back through more Morris Peterson. He has been so good.
Peterson 3 for 3 here in the third quarter. Shot the rainbow won't go. McKee the rebound. Iverson on the run. Won't go. Oakley the rebound. Iverson hopping mad. He thought he was fouled.
It is great in Philadelphia. When Iverson comes up the court, the whole crowd just rises to their feet.
Iverson just 7 of 22 from the field. Carter. Snow defended it beautifully and a jump ball. Eric Snow's initial defense forces that jump ball.
See, one of the things you were talking about, Allen Iverson, Mike, 7 of 22. Normally he gets to the free throw line about 10 times a game. That has not occurred. Today he's only shot 2. And Vince Carter trying to put the pressure on the defense. Nice play there by Eric Snow as he reached in to grab it. Had it not been a jump ball, Mutombo comes over and blocks the shot.
Carter, one of the few players in basketball, along with Kobe Bryant, who can overextend and still make something positive out of it. 10 on the shot clock.
Carter against Snow. That's a 3. Peterson trying to keep it alive, and he caroms into Iverson. And now Iverson will shoot 2 free throws as Peterson picks up his 3rd.
Well, that was a great hustle play by Mo Peterson. You don't want to take that away from him. The jump shot goes up by Carter. You're trying to track down that loose ball. Iverson just a step quicker and an inadvertent foul. But Allen Iverson, you know what, deserves to go to the free throw line. Bill, when you put the pressure on the defense and go in there like this guy does, on an occasional call like that, you can live with it because he gets hammered quite often during the course of the game.
Childs back in as Iverson with his just 3rd free throw attempt of the game. Peterson sits, but a strong third quarter for Morris Peterson.
A lot of pressure now on Vince Carter. With Davis on the bench, Was he in the locker room? Davis in the locker room still?
He went back to the locker room.
No front court scoring other than spot up shooting by Oakley. And with Aaron McKee or Eric Snow on, you get into that paint area and punish the short guy.
Carter leans in. Oakley tries to dive in for the rebound. And a loose ball foul is going to go against Charles Oakley. Eric Snow shoot free throws as Oakley picks up his second.
This is when the Philadelphia 76ers are at their best. Getting to the free throw line. Two loose balls. Both of them go to the 76ers. Vince Carter misses the little hanging shot. Oakley going to the front of the rim. All eyes are on Vince Carter. Look, three guys, and here comes Oakley. The loose ball, Eric Snow digs it out. Oakley pushes him out of bounds. So two free throws now on loose ball fouls to end this period here for the 76ers. Antonio Davis now back on the bench after being in the locker room.
Snow has had a strong game. 6 points to Snow as he hits the first. Eric Snow always credits his college coach, Judd Heathcote. Heathcote told him his sophomore year, you'll be a pro point guard for 10 years. Snow didn't believe him. Snow just said, hey, I just want to graduate. And he has really come into his own this year, despite all the injuries he's had to suffer with the ankle throughout the season. Last couple of years, he's really turned into a terrific player.
2-for-1 time, Toronto.
Looking inside, Williams comes to help. Five on the shot clock. Alvin Williams fires away. Ball knocked loose and taken by Tyrone Hill.
If the Sixers win this game today, it's because they've done a better job closing out quarters. The game was tied in a minute 20. Now they can go up six.
There's about a 6.5 second difference between shot and game clock as everybody in this place now on their feet. Iverson blocked by Williams. Williams got a piece of it. Going to go quickly. 5 seconds remaining in the quarter. And a blocking foul call on Tyrone Hill. That'll be his fifth. And Jerome Williams will shoot two.
It's hard to find fault with Allen Iverson, but he took that shot too soon against the clock. And what he did, he enabled Toronto now to take the miss and run out and get to the free throw line. So sometimes as an offensive player, you get a little excited. You take that shot too quickly. And here it is, the isolation. Alvin Williams does a terrific job. You see shot clock actually about 3 seconds still on the clock. But I think he could have maybe taken a couple more dribbles. But what that does is now it allows Jerome Williams to get to the line, or you make a couple free throws. It's going to be probably a two-point game going into the fourth period.
See Eddie Rush explaining to Hill, who will sit down.
But foul trouble. A major problem here now. Nothing off the bench. Injuries mounting.
Again, no Lynch and no Geiger. Williams is now just 7 of 14 from the line in this series.
Keep your eye on Vince Carter off this free throw. Todd McCullough's going to try to check him out. Jerome Williams, not a good free throw shooter. He must get his body on him so Carter does not rebound this miss.
3.2 seconds remaining.
Vince was calling for him to miss it.
Here comes Snow. Final seconds. And a count of the goals. Oh, just off the back of the rim.
As you hear the oohs from the crowd.
And that will end the third quarter. The Sixers, no field goals for nearly 6 minutes, the last 6 minutes of the period. We'll be right back after these messages and a word from the local station. Sixers by 3, fourth quarter coming up in game 7.
Hey, check to see. Hey, Dave, what was the free throw shooting in that period?
Επειδή το καλοκαίρι σας αρέσει να χαλαρώνετε, εμείς τρέχουμε περισσότερο. Sugar and spice.
Καλοκαίρι είναι πιο συναρπαστικό με Super Sport. Τώρα τα αθλητικά έχουν το δικό τους παιχνίδι. Super Sport Game. Interactive παιχνίδι για όλους τους φίλους των σπορ. Δοκιμάστε τις γνώσεις σας σε ένα quiz αθλητικών ερωτήσεων. Όταν δείτε το σήμα του Super Sport Game στους αγώνες του ελληνικού πρωταθλήματος ποδοσφαίρου, και μπάσκετ, πατήστε OK. Απαντήστε σωστά στις 4 ερωτήσεις και μπείτε στην κλήρωση για πολλά και πλούσια δώρα. Super Sport Game. Το παιχνίδι των πρωταθλητών. Μόνο στο Super Sport. Αποκλειστικά στην Nova. Παίξτε Super Sport Game. Παρέα με τα Pringles. Super Sport.
Toronto only had one turnover that quarter. Yeah, go ahead. Yep. There you go. There you go. All right, buddy. Of a game or just a quarter?
Fourth quarter is set to begin in Game 7. Three teams are already in the conference final. Of course, San Antonio and LA in the West. Milwaukee earlier today advanced to the East. And now it's up to Toronto and Philadelphia with one quarter to play and a three-point lead for the Sixers.
Well, Mike, the reason the 76ers have the lead, you talked about 548, no field goals. The free throw line is the difference. They got nine of their 19 points from the foul line, and you see the disparity, plus nine at the free throw line. That's why they are winning this game.
Iverson, Jermaine Jones with a fake, gets it signed with authority for Jermaine Jones. Jermaine Jones capitalizing on the ball movement on the perimeter, then realizing that Jerome Williams loves to come and gamble for steals. Just a little bit of a ball fake and in for the uncontested dunk.
Carter goes right at the top with the left hand. Oh, what a shot. Four-time defensive player of the year, Vince Carter with a spectacular left-handed drive.
Carter with 18, three-point lead for Philly. Opening minute here of the fourth. McKee, Iverson, Mutombo, Jones, and Snow out there for the Sixers. And a whistle, illegal defense called against Toronto. And that's their first, so just a warning.
The athleticism of the young stars that are dominating the NBA. Jermaine Jones throwing it down above the rim. We thought we saw a lot yesterday from Kobe Bryant. Vince Carter finally gets an opportunity on the move. Wrong foots the defense. Dikembe Mutombo finds himself pushed back with his head into the net. Vince Carter just too good, too creative.
Alvin Williams being attended to as Del Curry comes back in the game. Eight on the shot clock. Eric Snow steps up, puts it in.
That will be there. They're going to run and trap Iverson. They're going to force Eric Snow to make shots. They are not going to let Aaron McKee get those jump shots. So Eric Snow could be critical hitting that shot here, trying to close out this series.
Lead back up to five. Carter, Snow is out here. With the bad ankle of Snow. Childs for three. That's good. Chris Childs.
Quick double team by Iverson. And the way you handle those double teams is give it up before they get to you. That time Vince Carter perfectly setting up Chris Childs into a three-point rhythm.
Childs with 10 points and a foul away from the ball. First team foul. Third on Childs.
Allen Iverson coming and forcing that quick release pass, and Chris Childs' propensity for great clutch three-point shooting. He is a battle-tested playoff performer in his years with the Knicks. Aaron McKee, that's a two. That's a
so you can't run off Aaron McKee. Vince Carter went to help on Iverson. Aaron McKee can knock that shot down. You've got to force Eric Snow to take the shot. That's a defensive lap by Vince Carter.
McKee with 18. Khalif back up by four. Still plenty of time. We've just played over 2 minutes here in the fourth. Antonio Davis back in and puts it in.
Antonio Davis throughout this series has come back into the games after long stretches on the bench, long by Antonio Davis standards. And then he's been able to knock down those shots. Those are extremely difficult for not a natural, pure shooter.
Those shooting numbers coming against some very aggressive defensive both ends. Shot clock down to seven. McKee, left-handed, blocked by Davis. Boy, Davis doing it at both ends.
Toronto needs discipline right here.
Childs, dangerous shot, but he draws the foul. And Chris Childs shaking up. We'll go to the line for two. Dikembe Mutombo, call for his second foul.
What you love. You got Mutombo, Iverson battling virtually on every play, and these guys have one and two fouls.
So Childs will go there. As Doug mentioned earlier, game seven against Miami last season, as a member of the Knicks, he had 15 points when the Knicks beat the Miami Heat in Miami in the Eastern Conference semifinals.
The team that Larry Brown has on the floor right now, as we see Childs miss a free throw, is the team he likes to close the game with. He feels like he's got his best three perimeter players, Eric Snow, Iverson, and Aaron McKee, to play against Carter. He's got on the front line Jermaine Jones. We'll see Tyrone Hill later with Mutombo. So he likes to go small on the perimeter. That's why Eric Snow has to stay healthy out there right now. They need him in his defense.
Lenny Wilkins, on the other hand, still has a couple of substitutions. He's got Alvin Williams and Oakley both sitting on the bench. Critical juncture.
1 point game here in game seven. Jermaine Jones knocks it down. 22-year-old Jermaine Jones with 14 points.
Having his coming out party here today in a seventh game.
And the crowd getting up on its feet at the urging of Allen Iverson, waving the crowd up. Carter, Davis wide open, puts it in again.
Penetration and dish, championship style. Get into the paint, draw the entire defense, and then kick it out to one guy who's wide open.
Boy, Davis has just been brilliant in this postseason.
And also, to give Carter credit, he's creating wide open shots for him.
Carter has 7 assists. Iverson has 14 assists. So the big 50-point scorers distributing. Of course, they're well short of 50 today. Snow. Scoop layup won't go. Mutombo, another offensive rebound blocked by Curry.
9 offensive rebounds from Mutombo. Toronto on the run.
Childs off balance. Ball tipped and taken by Mutombo for a 16th rebound. Dangerous pass. Mutombo and Carter going for it. Inside. Foul. Shot won't go. Jermaine Jones nearly putting in a circus shot.
5 fouls now on Antonio Davis, with an eternity of time left.
But Jones coming up big, playing in place of the injured George Lynch.
But Jerome Williams is trying to help out against Allen Iverson, and Jermaine Jones right now, he's got a couple tip-ins in the game, so all of a sudden that jump shot feels pretty good to him. Attack that basket. Jermaine Jones once again put the pressure on the defense, draw the foul. He took the punishment, but he's going to earn 2 free throws.
And again, 5 fouls on Antonio Davis.
Επειδή το καλοκαίρι σας αρέσει να αλλάζετε ρυθμούς, εμείς σας προτείνουμε την ταχύτητα. Η πιο γρήγορη οδηγή του πλανήτη στις πιο δύσκολες διαδρομές. Τα πιο γρήγορα σερβίς στον κόσμο. Τα ταχύτερα center court της Λατινικής Αμερικής. Το καλοκαίρι σπάστε όλα τα ρεκόρ ταχύτητας μόνο στο Super Sport.
πρώτη φορά νιώθεις τόσο μέσα στο παιχνίδι. Supersport.gr. Κάνε παιχνίδι.
Η πρώτη θέση της κανονικής περίοδου είναι το μεγάλο στοίχημα για Περιστέρι και Παναθηναϊκό στο συγκλονιστικό φινάλε της Τετάρτης. Το γηπεδούχο Περιστέρι θέλει νίκη με διαφορά 10 πόντων, ενώ στον Παναθηναϊκό αρκεί να προστατεύσει τη διαφορά των 9 πόντων, με την οποία κέρδισε στον αγώνα του πρώτου γύρου. Δείτε αυτή την Τετάρτη Περιστέρι Παναθηναϊκός, ζωντανά και αποκλειστικά από το Super Sport.
13.
Great. Does that want to make a point for that?
Philadelphia leading by one. Big play from Jermaine Jones, a second-year man out of Georgia. He grew up in Georgia, went to the University of, was drafted by Atlanta back in 99 in the first round, but he was acquired by Philadelphia for a future first-rounder. And now, a guy who once led the SEC in scoring has been the beneficiary of some terrific passes from Allen Iverson.
Well, look at Allen Iverson, only 7 of 23. Look at the 14 assists. He's drawing so much attention, and that means somebody's going to be open, and you got to trust your teammates. You can't shoot against two or three people. Find the open man. Eric Snow buries the jumper. Penetration this time. Vince Carter leaves, and Aaron McKee steps up and knocks the shot down, and then Jermaine Jones rolls out and buries the jump shot. So when you look at Allen Iverson, 7 of 23, but the 14 assists, and also the 76ers have 13 offensive rebounds. Tumbo 9. So all that attention, Mike, has freed up second shots. That's why they still hold on to a one-point lead.
What we've seen from Iverson today is joy for the success of others. And that willingness to give it up and not try to force everything, to battle through the injuries. And we've seen so many guys in this series go down. Iverson playing with a severely bruised hip.
And Jones, for all good he's done, is now just 2 of 6 from the free throw line. Antonio Davis sitting down right now as the junkyard dog Jerome Williams has come back in. And throws it away. Curry in a bad pass.
This is where Toronto desperately needs the leadership of Oakley getting the ball to Vince Carter early in the shot clock. Vince never even got close to possession.
That's only the second turnover this half by Toronto. Snow gets it inside, and Jones is fouled again. So Jones, they call the foul against Jerome Williams. 13th foul, but Jones will shoot two more free throws, but again, he struggled from there.
And here's one of the problems. You start committing all these fouls early in the fourth period. You get into penalty. Now Allen Iverson starts to drive. You put your body on him, and you foul him, and you put him on the free throw line. So, Bill, you know the importance, especially in the fourth quarter, of getting into that penalty situation, especially when you got a star player. You put the onus on the official to blow the whistle when that guy goes to the basket.
You've got a greater than 2-1 disparity in this game between free throw shot attempts. And with Toronto settling for the perimeter game, unable to attack the basket and thus get to the free throw line, makes it very difficult to keep this crowd out of it.
5 minutes gone by the fourth. Philadelphia back up by 3. The Sixers, the number one seed in the East. The Raptors with a fifth seed. Avan Williams, the floater. Mutombo. Look at the effort from Mutombo, and a loose ball foul is going to go against Toronto. Dikembe Mutombo would not be denied on that rebound.
And Lenny Wilkins, who rarely complains, is right in the referee's face.
Jerome Williams, his third foul, and that's the 14th foul.
Mutombo, who has just been a giant on the boards today. 9 offensive rebounds. Keeping that ball tip, the second, third jump.
Iverson with the floater. Sixers back up by 5.
Lenny Wilkins needs a timeout here. Got a draw a play up so Vince Carter can get a shot. They have not allowed Vince Carter to touch the basketball here with their pressure defense.
And the First Union Center exploding once again.
Allen Iverson, been playing that point. He was waiting for the double team. The defense for Toronto was anticipating him, and Iverson went before it got there, able to tease him with the teardrop.
Just under 6.5 minutes remaining in game seven. Sixers a 5-point lead.
Hey, we got to make sure we keep the timeouts and fouls to give and all. Timeouts and fouls to give. We need to keep that up.
Philly only has one team foul. And Toronto's with the penalty, right?
Yes.
Philadelphia's 9-1. He's going to keep coming back for more. He's going to keep coming back for more, Ricky. Yep.
Croce of the Sixers, part of a deafening crowd here in Philadelphia as they lead by five. Allen Iverson again playing through injury as he's done so often.
Well, nobody loves Allen Iverson more than Pat Croce because he has that same kind of spirit. Now remember, when this young guy was in high school, he was the football player of the year. He is not going to shy away from contact. He's 7 for 23. He keeps going back in there for more. That's what stars are about. You're not worried about your percentage. You're now 8 for 24. You keep attacking the defense. 14 assists. He has got to take his team home now, Bill.
You don't win the MVP. You don't win the championship. You don't pack this building with wildly supportive fans unless you're willing to put it all on the line physically.
Alvin Williams hits the shot. Alvin Williams knocking it down. That's a two-pointer.
Scoring out of timeouts. Alvin Williams sat for so long. As Antonio Davis is back sitting on the bench right now. They have not been successful with Davis on the bench.
Just past the midway point of the fourth quarter. McKee, tough falling away shot. Oakley with a rebound. And a foul call on Jermaine Jones. Not a smart play as he got tangled up with Childs. That's his third and the team's second.
But Chris Childs is very good at getting guys to fall for that type of play.
This is such a critical time for Toronto with Antonio Davis on the bench. They have got to stay close. They cannot dig themselves a hole so that he can come back in the game and maybe help them finish this game off.
Raptors are 3-0 in elimination games in these playoffs. Two against the Knicks, one against the Sixers.
Get to the hoop here.
Carter, Childs for three. Way short, ball deflected out of bounds by Jerome Williams.
And the Sixers will take it.
And Lenny Wilkins coming right now with Antonio Davis. Even though he's got the five fouls, even though he's got the bad arm.
Carter just one for one. He's only taken one shot here in this fourth quarter, but the Sixers defense trying to force it out of his hands.
Give it back to Iverson here.
Snow, five on the shot clock. Oh, Childs, and a foul call on Childs. Snow will shoot two.
Now, Chris Childs has a tendency to get very emotional, and when he does, sometimes he commits fouls. It allows his emotions to get the best of him. Eric Snow, contested shot. You don't foul him and put him on the line.
Not after three dribbles.
I mean, he had no place to go, and you see Antonio Davis back in the game, and you see what's happened with him on the bench here in the second period. So he has got to stay in the ball game to finish it out, and he's got to play through that tough arm injury that he has. It'll be a tough 5 minutes here for Antonio Davis.
Snow hits the first. 11 points for Snow, who was questionable with the ankle injury. Held back in, and Jermaine Jones, 16 points for Jones, starting in place to the injured George Lynch. What a performance from the second-year player out of Georgia.
Now, Chris Giles leaving the game, and Del Curry's coming in. Why? Because if they're going to run a double team, Alvin Williams and Del Curry are both terrific three-point shooters. So now when Carter penetrates, he's going to find a shooter on the perimeter.
Mutombo stepped out of bounds when he touched the ball, but the Raptors will get it back.
Chris Giles is so good in the clutch. Take him out for 30 seconds. Let him think about it. Think he's out for long. And get back in there and get this job done.
Under 5 minutes remaining. Which team will play the Bucks in the next round? Carter misses the three. Davis the big rebound.
Bring it out. Let somebody else make the play. You've already contributed to your team here.
Davis listens to you, Bill. Carter splits the defenders, gets inside, and he's hammered. Carter hammered, and he'll shoot two.
Talking about putting your body in harm's way.
And you know what? What it must feel like to be able to jump that high, to be able to hang up long enough to be able to do that. Look at his crossover, and he gets in the air, two guys, and finally gets the contact.
That was your game, Doug.
Oh, no question. I used to take the throw right at you, Bill.
Carter now at 19.7 assists. So much made about what he did earlier today, but it doesn't seem like it's had any effect in terms of what he's done on the floor.
I agree with that. This has not been a distraction. Don't look and say that he's 6 for 17. They've been swarming him, but more importantly, he's given the ball up to his teammates. Now is when you're going to judge Vince Carter. 4:35 to go. It's a two-point game.
Iverson finds some room, flips it up, shot won't go. Ball tipped out of bounds, and it's still Philly ball.
You've got to be able to dominate your defensive backboard if you expect to win on the road. Larry Brown's going to talk this one over with a 20-second timeout.
So a 20-second timeout called by Larry Brown. His team with the ball in a two-point lead here in the fourth quarter.
Anyone?
Yes, we got to stay on top of that, and fouls
oh,
to give.
Oh, way too many Nick references.
But I don't think it's had any effect. He's playing.
No, that's why I said.
Yeah, that was good. Both teams with ample timeouts remaining. Just under 4.5 minutes left here in the fourth quarter. Toronto already in the penalty. Sixers still with a foul to give. Vince Carter, 20 points, 7 assists, and his team down by 2, but Sixers have the ball.
Get something going for Allen Iverson here. Get him on the move. He's had to struggle against double teams in a dead set offensive situation, virtually every possession. Get running.
Iverson, good defense from Alvin Williams. Snow puts it in. Eric Snow again with a big shot.
Although he's not a great shooter, that's why Larry Brown wants him on the floor to finish games. He and McKee to go with Iverson in that backcourt.
13 points for Eric Snow. 4-point Philly lead.
This Hill is at Carter. That Vince Carter's got to explode.
And Oakley knocks it down.
But that's what you do. You don't try to post Oakley. Slide him out, penetrate, bring his man. Oakley is a very, very good spot-up shooter.
And again, Carter with the pass. That's 8 assists for Vince Carter. Williams keeps
keeping Iverson in front of him beautifully. Six on the shot clock. McKee knocks it down. Aaron McKee's got 20. Sixers back up by four.
You better strap it on right now. No flopping. The referees are not going to bail you out with a whistle.
I think they left their whistles at the scorer's table.
A very experienced crew. McKee back on Carter. Mutombo picks him up. Davis finds the opening. Stolen by Eric Snow. And Snow wisely pulls it back out. He didn't like the numbers.
Look at his limping gait. Now, quickly to Iverson, early in the shot clock.
McKee. It's good. Aaron McKee puts Philadelphia up by six. And a timeout, 22nd timeout by the Raptors with 2:54 remaining.
Well, the number six has been very lucky for Aaron McKee. Sixth man of the year, he puts his team up by six, less than three to go, and you can feel the energy in this building.
McKee leading all scores with 22 here in game seven. Yeah. That's his ties his career high. 16. He's got 16.
16. See the one thing, and you saw it in the Knicks series, Latrell Sprewell went at Carter late the game defensively. They're having McKee go at Carter right now. He's going to have to strap it on defensively.
Yeah.
But this Freewell went at him in the New York series.
Those 16 assists, the most he's had in the regular season or the playoffs. It's obvious both defenses trying to force the ball out of the hands of the stars, and others have picked up the slack.
The ability to make your teammate the star, the final step to the championship puzzle. Allen Iverson delivering today, and then with Aaron McKee taking it right at Vince Carter, no defense for that.
Well, Vince Carter's going to have to take the challenge defensively. The last two plays, Philadelphia's gone right at him and scored. And we saw that in the New York series. When the game was close, Freewell would go at him. Now Carter has to answer the challenge on the defensive end against Aaron McKee, who's playing him on the other end of the floor.
Little full court pressure. Curry, Oakley, Carter, Davis, and Alvin Williams right now out there for Toronto. Snow doing a good job stopping Curry from putting up that three. Davis gets inside, left-handed, banks it in. Antonio Davis, another terrific play. He's got 23.
With Lenny Wilkins coming with Del Curry, if Del Curry's not going to take that shot, he's not going to give you a whole lot else. Chris Childs could never get back into that game.
has made a number of big plays at both ends of the floor. McKee against Carter. Aaron McKee. Short. Davis, another rebound, his ninth.
That was good defense that time by Carter. Got a hand up and forced a tough shot.
2 minutes to go in game seven. Curry, Snow again, right up on him.
Well, they're just closing out magnificently on Del Curry.
Curry for three. Way short, and Iverson with the rebound.
And he shot that one a little bit too quickly. Right now, he's having a difficult time getting his shot off. He forced that one.
Raptors need another big stop.
Look at the difference in Philadelphia. They get Iverson the ball early in the shot clock. And then he doesn't have to worry too much about it.
Snow, Tyrone Hill, in and out. The Tumbo's tip won't go, and they get a new 24.
Just leave it right there with Iverson.
Remember now, Toronto already in the penalty, so if Iverson drives and gets fouled, he will shoot free throws.
Iverson saying, get out of the way. Eight on the shot clock. There goes Iverson. Blocked by Alvin Williams. Ball knocked loose. Carter tripped up. Crowd wanted to travel. Curry for three. Bam! El Curry from downtown. And it's a one-point game.
Now, Bill, you want a child's in the game.
No wonder he's in the game.
52 seconds remaining. Raptors will not go away. Anxious moments here at the First Union Center. Iverson puts it up. Way off the mark. Rebound Aaron McKee. And McKee gets it back out to Snow.
Well, they don't want to foul right now. There's almost an 8-second differential. They want to stop. Even if Philly scores, they'll have plenty of chance to get a playoff.
Snow setting it up. 9 on the shot clock. Iverson against Williams. Eric Snow won't go. Davis the rebound. Alvin Williams will bring it across, and they'll call timeout. 3.6 seconds remaining. Finish. The Raptors will have a chance to win it at the buzzer.
What a game. Great plays, great defensive sequences. That big three by Curry. Now his team has a chance. 3.6 to go. They're down only one.
They could have called that timeout immediately, though, because you can advance the ball.
And also a big point. Philly has a foul to give here.
Επειδή το καλοκαίρι σας αρέσει να χαλαρώνετε, εμείς τρέχουμε περισσότερο. Το καλοκαίρι είναι πιο συναρπαστικό με Supersport. Το Supersport παρουσιάζει την αθλητική σειρά Καλοκαίρι 2001. Ανανεωθείτε με ρούχα που αξίζει να φορέσετε. Η νέα σειρά του Supersport περιλαμβάνει μπλούζες, παντελόνια και σόρτς μαγιό. Τηλεφωνήστε στο 6602339 ή συμπληρώστε το δελτίο παραγγελίας που θα βρείτε στο TV Magazine και ντυθείτε καλοκαιρινά αποκλειστικά από το Super Sport.
They have to go immediately. If they take any sort of hesitation to their attack, they're going to be out of luck.
Now the Raptors still have a timeout left. And again, Philadelphia with a foul to give. So expect the inbound and a foul after a couple of seconds. Obviously, they have to be careful not to foul in the act of shooting.
Well, if you're Philadelphia, you want Toronto to throw the ball back towards half court. Make them use some clock and then take the foul. You don't want them to throw it deep in the corner where they can get a catch and shoot or where they're in the offensive area. So you want the ball going back towards half court.
Put this line underneath the basket so that when they can make the inbound pass to the 15-foot region of the offensive end.
It all comes down to the final play. Sixers by one. Raptors with the ball. Carter nearly falls down, and there's the foul again. McKee waited the perfect opportunity just before Carter's shot, and there's 2 seconds remaining, so the Raptors have to inbound again.
Very slow clock.
I was going to say, I looked up at 1.6.
Larry Brown agrees. He's going over to the scorer's table.
That's a big break for Toronto because now you can catch the ball and get a dribble, and now you can't take a foul.
And they'll call their final timeout. So the Raptors out of timeouts. Obviously, they'll have to get it in, so any kind of ball pressure could cause some problems. So Lenny Wilkins uses his final timeout with 2 seconds to go and his team down by one. Anxious moments in Philadelphia. Game 7 coming down to the final play. Where's the copy?
I don't know yet.
Okay.
Probably this.
As soon as you know. Fun as this, huh?
See, the one thing that defensively you'll have to shadow the guy and not let him throw the ball down the sideline. Guy playing the guy out.
Sixers by one, but the Raptors with the ball. 2 seconds to go. Toronto out of timeouts.
And they've got Del Curry inbounding the ball. They're going to set screens for Vince Carter coming to it.
Also watch the quick pass to Curry after he inbounds. Curry has it. Carter trying to get free. Carter at the buzzer. No good. And the Sixers hold on and advance to the conference finals.
74-85. The 76ers will play in the Eastern Conference Finals, and they'll go against the Milwaukee Bucks. What a performance on the road for the Toronto Raptors as their wonderful ride in the postseason comes to an end. Carter had a good look at it. Terrific look. He back cut after he received the initial screen from Charles Oakley. Philadelphia anticipated that. And then Carter bursts over with that explosive quickness. The pump fake, the defender flies right by. Had time, had a look, squared away. You can't ask for more than that.
And the celebration begins. The Toronto Raptors coming one shot short of a huge upset here in the second round of the playoffs. Carter finishes with 20 points, 9 assists.
Shoulder square, a great look at it.
Tyrone Hill, though, did a good job defending to make Carter fall away on that shot. Defense once again comes to the forefront for the 76ers. And the first two games of the conference finals will be here. Sixers and Bucks. Let's send it now to Andrea Joyce with some happy people.
Down here. Allen, what was going through your mind when Del Curry hit that shot, pulled it within one in the final minute of the game?
No, I was just, you know, I knew that they had some more time. We had to get off a shot. I missed a shot, but my teammates just kept fighting. That's what having teammates is all about, you know. They came through me, you know, I struggled all game, and they came through like they're supposed to.
This is the most emotional we have seen you after a victory. Larry Brown said that these are the kinds of games that define players and define franchises. What does this say about this team that they've been able to come back like this and win this series?
That we're a team. You know, we're a team. As simple as that, you know. Don't get no better than this. You know, in the locker room, outside of the locker room, we're always a team. We always look out for each other. We always do a lot of things with each other. We're a team. For the first time in my life, I'm on a team.
Is this the best moment of your career?
Huh?
Is this the best moment of your career?
The best moment of my career is just getting drafted and just being put in a predicament to do these things. And I thank God for it.
Okay, we had Aaron McKee here. I think we lost him in the crowd. We're going to send it back to you, Mike.
All right, Andrea. Arrive home safely. Allen Iverson said he was not ready for summer vacation. Well, summer vacation is still put on hold, at least for one more series, as the Sixers will play the Bucks. Eastern Conference Final. First two games again right back here at the First Union Center. Again, our final score, Game 7 from Philly. The Sixers 88 and the Raptors 87 as Philadelphia now in the Eastern Conference Finals. Don't forget, next weekend, Memorial Day weekend, we'll have plenty of NBA playoff action. Of course, what a great day for the NBA fan. The Bucks winning at home in their Game 7 against Charlotte. Now waiting for their opponent. And the 76ers did the same. They won at home despite a gallant effort from the Toronto Raptors. Vince Carter got a degree and nearly
had it. Well, Sonny Anderson had the opportunity to get his first goal for his country there. Timed his run to perfection, just got a nick on it, but the defender's done well enough. Ramon who sets it up, Anderson the touch and the goalkeeper. Alioum has covered it well.